Hi, my name is Maida. I'm from the Tasty team here in Los Angeles, and today we are going to be showing you how to do mesmerizing Brazilian desserts. I was born and raised in São Paulo, Brazil, and lived there for the first 24 years of my life. After I moved to US, I realized brigadeiros were the only Brazilian dessert people knew, and that makes total sense. It's the most beloved party snack. It's pretty much sweet condensed milk, butter, and chocolate. So Tasty has done a bunch of brigadeiros. There is a trend of doing giant food in Tasty Demise. So for this video, they did a 1 kilogram brigadeiro. I was just in Brazil. I went to my friend's house at 10 p.m. just to pay her a quick visit. And all of a sudden she was like, oh my God, you're here and you haven't had brigadeiro. You need the real thing in a pan right now. That's the most simple version you can make. And my friend just like watched me eat it. And doing at home like that is what we call the pan or spoon brigadeiro. Sitting around the table with your friends, each person has their own spoon, and it's like the ultimate way to eat real brigadeiro. The American version of carrot cake is so different from the Brazilian one. I remember the first time that I ordered carrot cake in US, and it looked like white thing with a lot of spices, and I was like, no, this is not carrot cake. And I think it goes both ways. When Americans see a Brazilian carrot cake, they're like, oh my God, it's so orange. What goes in it? And it's like, well, carrots. But it is one of those basic types of cakes. The British people have the famous afternoon tea. In Brazil, we definitely have the afternoon coffee, and carrot cake would always be on the table. When we started making videos for Tasty Demise, it was always a question, what is a Brazilian staple that we can just transform into something new and cool? We've done carrot cake pops, carrot cake churros, and carrot cake cheesecake. It's one of those things that people have their own recipe for it. And this version is just combining carrot cake with brownie on a bundt cake, and it looks really beautiful. It's not something that I think anybody has ever done. It's not traditional. Brownie is not something big in Brazil, but people still love it. It's pretty much chocolate cake with carrot cake. It's brigadeiro that goes on top of carrot cake in Brazil. Obviously, we really love our sugar. So a trifle is also one of our most famous desserts. You're pretty much layering crackers, cream chocolate. It can also come in like different flavors. You can do like a key lime pie or strawberry, or people just get creative. But the idea is always the same. You're just layering chocolate, cream, and crackers, and it becomes the sort of like cold pie. So the name in Portuguese is pavé, comes from the French for pavement. There's a really stupid dad joke that everybody does. Bear with me if this doesn't make sense, but pavé sounds like pra ver, the verb to see in Portuguese. So every time the trifle is on the table, somebody will have to do the joke, oh, but is this to see or to eat? It's really stupid. Trifle is one of my favorite desserts. You're always gonna find it in any like family gathering or birthdays, and it's one of our staples as well. Last time I was in Brazil, trifle or pavé was the first thing that I had, and the first thing that my husband had, and he couldn't stop talking about it. He's American, he's never had it before, and to the end of the trip, he kept repeating how it was one of the most amazing things he had while he was there. I bet the French version that inspired trifle is really nice and fancy, but Brazilians love to take something and just Brazilify it and make it in a way that it's cheaper and really sweet and that anybody can make it. Jello is a really famous dessert in Brazil. It's really common, it's really cheap, it comes in a lot of different flavors, and sweet condensed milk is in everything. Families will have 4 or 5 cans of sweet condensed milk in their pantries all the time. Usually Brazilian desserts are really, really sweet. I didn't realize that until talking to non-Brazilian folks that were always like, oh my God, everything here is so sweet. And I kind of started realizing that that might be true. A really famous and cool way to eat Jello is when you mix different flavors and colors together with sweet condensed milk, and it gives you this bigger, like, mosaic version of a gelatin. And this is such a classic and cheap way to make beautiful desserts. It has different colors and an amazing taste. It looks beautiful. So it is something that people do when they want to impress, when they want to bring something nice to the table without, like, breaking their buck. Cheesecakes are not really authentic Brazilian dessert, but you're still making it really cheap, creating a new way to serve it that would make it look even nicer. So because it looks so beautiful, people try to impress and bring it to the table for family gatherings and Christmas party. This is also a favorite among our Tasty Demise fans. So I moved to US about 3.5 years ago, straight from Brazil, to study a bit more. I really love US. It has given me a lot. My husband, my cats, my job, but also I miss Brazil very much. It's where all of my friends and family still are. It is a really beautiful country. People are so warm and welcoming. People always say, oh, you're from Brazil? I would love to go to Brazil. And they never do. And I'm saying you should definitely go. Book a ticket right now and go. You're not gonna regret it. Make sure you have some of those desserts while you're there.
Which one of these would you try first?
Oh, yes!